Antonio Lauro wrote the prelude, the Registro that I'm going to play. He actually wrote it while he was in prison. He was a political prisoner in Venezuela in the 1950s for several months after the democratically elected government was removed. And he wrote the Suite Venezolana while he was in prison, and also some other pieces. But it's in a style of, it's very reminiscent of the way the Venezuelan popular guitarists would accompany songs. They must have played very, very well to be able to play like this. And then the three other pieces are Venezuelan waltzes, or valses venezolanos. And there's several rhythms that you'll hear in this piece. You're familiar with the waltz, the usual waltz rhythm, which is, well, that's the only rhythm that you're not going to hear. You'll hear many others, but you won't hear that. Thank you. reasons that Antonio Lauro became a guitarist and a composer was because he had the chance to hear Agustin Barrios play a couple of concerts in Caracas, in Venezuela. And he was so impressed and so moved at what he heard that he decided, well, the guitar is very important artistically, and decided to devote himself to it as well. These are two preludes. They're not the most famous of Barrios' works, but they're both really lovely. And the first one is, I think, very, very Chopin-esque and very intense. The second one is titled, subtitled Homage to Bach, and is very much in the style of one of the fast movements of the unaccompanied sonatas for violin.
Thank you.
unaccompanied violin, and the composer Johann Sebastian Bach wrote six sets of pieces, three sonatas and three partitas for the unaccompanied violin. And one of them, the second of the three partitas in D minor, he wrote four dances and then a last movement, which was longer than all of the other dances put together. And that's this piece, the Chaconne. And so very often you only hear this piece. And it's in three parts. It was probably written at a time that was actually a really sad time in Bach's life. He was had been traveling and came home and found out that his wife had died. And it would have been Maria Barbara. And so he wrote these pieces, and there has been a lot of research about this piece, and it has been discovered that many parts of this piece actually fit and play with certain Bach chorales that deal with death and resurrection. And the piece itself is in three parts, which people think has a lot to do with the Holy Trinity, and it wouldn't surprise me. And basically, the first part begins and grows increasingly intense. The second part becomes is much more sort of meditative and like a growl for quite a while. And then the third part returns to the first key. First part's in major, second part's in minor, and then, other way around. First part's in minor, second part's in major, and the third part goes back to the minor key.
excerpts from the poems, which the poet Juan Ramon-Jimenez wrote. This is a very long cycle. It's about 100, over 100 poems, and he selected 8. And he simply had over the beginning of each piece excerpts from the poems. And the poem, the cycle actually won a Nobel Prize for Literature in 1957. And as Raphael said, it's about this man's travels through Spain with his donkey Platero. And so they have all sorts of little adventures and things that happen. And like all of our pets, eventually they pass away. And so there's one poem about that. And there's one poem after that where he's kind of posthumously talking to Platero. There's one motive that you'll hear in the first movement, which is a description of Platero, which is... And you'll also hear that in the seventh movement, but it won't sound quite like that. It will be much different and much more dramatic. So, whenever
you can. Okay, I will read. I hope Sauble speaks Spanish. I know like 3 or 4 people here do, but he's going to translate it for you. Platero es pequeño, peludo, suave. Solo los espejos de azabache de sus ojos son duros cual dos escarabajos de cristal negro. Lo llamo dulcemente Platero. Y viene a mí con un trotecillo alegre que parece que se ríe en no sé qué cascabaleo ideal.
Platero is small, fluffy, soft. Only the jet black mirrors of his eyes are as hard as 2 scarabs of black crystal. I call him sweetly, Platero, and he comes to me at a gay little trot as though he were laughing. Thank you.
Vestido de luto con mi barba nazarena, debo cobrar un extraño aspecto cabalgando en la blandura gris de platero. Los chiquillos gitanos, aceitosos y peludos, las tensas barrigas tostadas, corren detrás de nosotros chillando largamente, el loco, el loco, el loco.
Dressed in mourning for my Nazarene beard, I must cut a strange figure as I ride on Platero's soft gray back. The little gypsy children, greasy and long-haired, with their taut tan bellies, run after us, screeching at length, el loco, el loco, el loco.
La azotea se domina todo, ventanas con una muchacha en camisa que se peina descuidada, cantando, el río con su barco que no acaba de entrar, tú, platero, bebiendo en el pilón sin verme o jugando como un tonto con el gorrión o la tortuga.
The roof terrace, it dominates everything, windows with a girl in her nightshirt combing her hair without a care, singing. The river, with a boat that never seems to reach port. You, Platero, drinking at the trough without seeing me or playing like a silly fool with a sparrow or a tortoise.
Thank you.
es grande como el buey tío, pero se enternece igual que un niño con platero. Y si ve una flor o un pajarillo, se ríe de pronto. Luego, ya sereno, mira largamente del lado del cementerio viejo. Mi niña, mi pobrecita niña.
Darbon. Darbon, Platero's doctor, is as large as a spotted ox. But he becomes as tender as a child with Platero, and if he sees a flower or a songbird, he immediately laughs. Then, serene once more, he takes a long look in the direction of the old cemetery. My little girl, my poor little girl.
Paseo por los hondos caminos del estío, colgados de tiernas madreselvas, cuán dulcemente vamos.
Paseo, along the deep paths of the summer, hung with tender honeysuckle, how sweetly we walk.
Thank you.
La cogimos asustados con la ayuda de la mandadera y entramos en casa anhelantes, gritando, una tortuga, una tortuga. Luego la regamos porque estaba muy sucia y salieron como de una calcomanía, unos dibujos de oro y negro.
The tortoise. We picked it up with the help of the nanny and went into the house, excited, shouting, a tortoise, a tortoise. Then we ran water over it because it was so dirty. And then, as if from a decal, gold and black patterns appeared.
Encontré a Platero echado en su cama de paja. Parecía su pelo rizoso, ese pelo de estopa apolillada de las muñecas viejas que se cae al pasarle la mano en una polvorienta tristeza.
Death. I found Platero on his bed of straw. His curly coat was like that moth-eaten tow hair on old dolls, which if you run your hand over it, crumbles into dusty sadness.
Thank you.
platero y su tierra. Tú, platero, estás solo en el pasado. Pero, ¿qué más te da el pasado a ti que vives en lo eterno, que, como yo aquí, tienes en tu mano, grana como el corazón de Dios, el sol de cada aurora?
To Platero and his earth. You, Platero, are alone in the past. But what does the past matter to you now that you live in eternity, holding in your hand, as I do here, red as the heart of God everlasting, the sunshine of each dawn? And Raphael was
very kind to me in the past as well. He presented me in a concert in a festival in the Dominican Republic, and it seems that it was, although it was December, and supposedly the end of hurricane season, that the weather didn't seem to pay attention. So we actually had to perform this concert during a tropical storm. And while I was playing, the wind blew enough that the power actually went out for a bit. And it seems, obviously I came here, it seems that wherever we do this, the wind follows us. But at least so far, the power has gone. Spanish composer. He grew up in Seville, or Sevilla, and was obviously had plenty of opportunities to hear the folk music of the area. And so you're going to hear a lot of things that sound like flamenco in here, in this piece. And then you're going to hear some things that don't. It's kind of, there's two sides to this piece. There's the flamenco side, and there's a sort of French, late Romantic, impressionist side, which is very different. And you'll hear immediately when those two things happen. Thank you.
Thank you.